Welcome to a video on permutations. The goals of this video are to evaluate factorials, use permutations to solve problems, and also to determine the number of permutations with indistinguishable items. A permutation is an arrangement or ordering of items. So the main thing to remember for a permutation is that the order matters. So if we want to know how many different ways three students can line up to purchase a new textbook reader, this would be a permutation since the order matters. So if we label the three students A, B, and C, let's see if we can list the possible arrangements. Well, we could have A, B, C, and then if student B and C changed order, we would have A, C, B. Now we'll let student B be first, so we'd have B, A, C, or B, C, A. And then lastly, if student C is first, we'd have C, A, B, or C, B, A. So we say the number of permutations would be 6. Now we can model this situation in another way. You can think of the three positions in line. And if we take a look at the first position in line, there would be three ways it could be filled with student A, B, or C. Now once the first position in line is filled, there would only be two possibilities for the second position. And then lastly, once the first two positions are filled, there's only one option for that last position. So using the counting principle idea, if we multiply 3 times 2 times 1, that would also give us 6 possible ways that three students can line up. Now this brings us to the idea of factorial. N factorial gives a number of permutations for n items. And this is the notation for n factorial. N factorial is equal to n times n minus 1 times n minus 2 all the way down to times 2 times 1. Now n does have to be a whole number, and by definition 0 factorial is equal to 1. So if we take a look at 3 factorial, this means we start with a factor of 3, and then we're going to multiply by factors that decrease by 1 until we end up with a factor of 1. So we'd have 3 times 2 times 1, which is equal to 6. So 6 factorial would be 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. This would be 720. Let's go ahead and show where the factorial button is on the calculator. If I wanted to determine, let's say, 12 factorial, I could just type in 12, press math, arrow over to probability, and it's option 4. And there we go. And remember that n factorial does represent the number of ways we can permute or order n distinct items. Distinct meaning we can tell them apart. Let's take a look at permutation notation. Permutations of n items taken r at a time is written using this notation, and again represents a number of permutations of n items r at a time. So if you take a look at this notation here, this is the permutation of 7 items taken 3 at a time. This is the permutation of 15 items taken 5 at a time. And this is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial. And sometimes this is also written n permute r as well, depending on what textbook you read. So if we want to evaluate the permutations of 7 items taken 3 at a time, it would be 7 factorial divided by n minus r factorial. Well, 7 minus 3 factorial, that would be equal to 7 factorial over 4 factorial. Let's go ahead and expand this. This would be 7 times 6 all the way down to times 1. All over 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And you'll see this does simplify. 4 over 4 is 1, 3 over 3 is 1, and so on. So this is equal to 7 times 6 times 5, which equals 210. I'd like to pause for a moment and take a look at this problem again. If we have 7 items and we want to permute 3 of them at a time, we could model this with 3 positions. And we have 7 choices for the first position, 6 for the second, and 5 for the fourth, which as expected gives us the same result of 210. Okay, for the second question we have 15 permute 5. That's equal to 15 factorial over 15 minus 5 factorial, which is equal to 15 factorial over 10 factorial. Let's go ahead and start expanding this. Now notice from here on out, that would be 10 times 9 times 8 and so on. So that would be 10 factorial. And And the reason I'm stopping there is because the denominator is also 10 factorial. So we'll notice that 10 factorial over 10 factorial simplifies out. For the same reason up here, we could have left this as 4 factorial and 4 factorial. Let's go ahead and use our calculator to determine this product. That's going to equal 360,360. Okay, let's take a look at a couple problems now. If a class has 28 students, how many different arrangements can 5 students give a presentation to the class? Well, the order does matter, so this is a permutation. So we have the permutation of 28 items taken 5 at a time. So that's 28 factorial over 28 minus 5 factorial. That's equal to 28 factorial over 23 factorial. Now I also want to show you how you can evaluate a permutation in this form on the graphing calculator. And this is why sometimes you might prefer to use the notation that I showed on the previous screen as 28 permute 5 items. This is more of how we type it into the calculator. So in order to evaluate this on the calculator, we would have to type in 28, press math over to probability, and you'll see the permutation option as option 2. And then we have to type in the value of R, which was 5, 11,793,600. Let's go ahead and evaluate it in this form too to show that it would result in the same value. So we have 28 factorial, remember that was under math, probability option 4, divided by 23 factorial, option 4, and you can see the number of permutations is obviously the same. How many ways can the letters of the word phoenix be arranged? Well, the first thing we have to notice is that every letter in this word is different, and that's important, and we'll see in just a moment. So we have 7 different or 7 distinct letters, and each time we arrange them, we want to use all the letters. So this would be a permutation of 7 items taken 7 at a time. Again, it can be written in this form as well. And it's equal to n factorial, 7 factorial, over 7 minus 7 factorial, that's 0 factorial. And by definition, 0 factorial is equal to 1. So this is 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So let's go back to the calculator. We're going to have 7 factorial, or we could type in 7 math probability option 2, 7 permute 7 items. And of course, the result is the same, 5040. Let's take a look at one more idea. Sometimes we have a permutation where the items are indistinguishable or we can't tell them apart, which means that when we switch the order of the items, we wouldn't be able to tell because you can't tell the items apart. And here's how we'll address this type of permutation. The number of different permutations of n objects, where there are n sub 1 indistinguishable items, n sub 2 indistinguishable items, and so on, is given by this formula. So we'll take n factorial and then divide by n sub 1 factorial, n sub 2 factorial, and so on, where n sub 1 and n sub 2 are the number of indistinguishable items of each type. For example, how many ways can the letters of the word mathematics be rearranged? So we'll first count the number of letters in total. So we have 11 different letters, and now we have to count, and now we have to determine the indistinguishable items. Well, these two m's are indistinguishable, so we must divide by 2 factorial since there's 2 m's. Let's go ahead and cross those off so we keep track of this. Notice there's also 2 a's, so we have to divide by another 2 factorial. And anything else? Looks like there's also 2 t's, so we have to divide by 2 factorial. Now, if there were 3 of anything, we would divide by 3 factorial. So what we're doing here is we're dividing out the permutations that we would not be able to tell they were different because of the letters that look exactly the same. Let's go ahead and find this value. So we have 11 factorial, and we're going to divide this by, since 2 factorial is 2 times 1, the denominator would be 8. Let's just divide by 8. And there we have it, 4,989,600 different permutations. Let's see if we can do one more. How many ways can you order 3 blue marbles, 4 red marbles, and 5 green marbles? Again, the order matters, so it's a permutation, but the marbles of the same color look identical, so they're indistinguishable. So we have a total of 3 plus 4 plus 5 marbles. That would be 12 marbles. So we have 12 factorial. And then since there are 3 indistinguishable blue marbles, we divide by 3 factorial. 4 indistinguishable red marbles, so we divide by 4 factorial. And the same for the 5 green marbles. So this quotient will tell us the number of arrangements that we can make with these marbles, given the marbles with the same color look exactly the same. So we have 12 factorial in the numerator, and we'll divide this by 3 factorial times 4 factorial times 5 factorial. So we have 27,720 different ways we can order these 12 marbles. Okay, I hope you found the video helpful. Have a good day.